Assalamualaikum, my dear students of class 7. How are you? Hope all of you are well by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to our online platform NIEVS Home School. This is Muhammad Abul Kalam, Assistant Teacher of English, National Ideal English Version School. Today, I am going to conduct an English second paper class for the students of class 7. Our today's topic is narration, interrogative. I have written in short form interrogative, imperative, optative, and exclamatory sentence. I repeat, it is narration, interrogative, imperative, optative, and exclamatory sentence. Dear learners, look here. This is our lecture number 13 and SW number 12. I repeat, this is our lecture number 13 and SW number 12 on our annual term syllabus. Dear students, in our previous class, we learned the definition of narration and the basic rules of narration. Inshallah, we will learn the other or the rest part of narration. In these connections, if you remain active to the class, to the whole class, definitely the narration in the look here, narration, interrogative, imperative, optative, and exclamatory will be clear crystal to you. So I request all of my students of class 7 to give your maximum attention. Let's start our class. Number 1, at first rules. So look at the title, it is written interrogative sentence. In the right side of our board, I have written only INT, the short form. So it is written interrogative sentence. Rules number 1, when the reported speech is an interrogative sentence, the reporting verb say or tell is changed into asked or inquire of. Look here, it is changed into asked or inquire of. Structure, look at the structure. Structure is very important to understand your rules. Subject plus ask, and ask, inquire or inquires of and inquired of. So look, that means all tense. This one is the ask, definitely will be in past structure, and here it's also it will be in past structure. I am going to tell you object and if any, if whether subject of the reported speech plus verb plus extension. This is the structure. Now if you look at the example, it will clarify you. So look at, it will give a clear concept to you. Look at the direct example. Look at the first one, it is written, I am said to his sister, will you go to school? So in the indirect sentence, we will write, I am asked her. So look here, I am writing, I am asked or inquiry of. I am writing only this one, asked his sister, if, so look here, it is written if or whether, we have selected or we have written if she, so look here you represent she, that means his sister, if she, it is written will, okay, it will be in past form. We all know in my previous class I told you the past form is will would be would go to school, full stop. So I am telling again the indirect example, I am asked her sister if she would go to school. Dear students, look here, in interrogative sentence there is no that, that means we will not write that. I am asked his sister if she would go to school, then full stop. Now rules number 2, if the reported speech begins with interrogative pronoun, for example who, whom, whose, what, which, etc., we call them also WH questions, or interrogative adverb, for example why, where, how, where, etc., the particular interrogative pronouns or adverb is used in the indirect speech as a conjunction. That means we will not change them, we will use them in the, as a conjunction. So look, structure, subject plus ask, object if any, then interrogative pronoun, adverb, plus subject of the reported speech plus verb plus extension. So look here, direct, he said to me, where do you live? Okay, look again, He asked me, past tense, where I, so look here, you represents me, that means I, where I lived, past from, live in present from, here we will write past from. So look here, he asked me where I lived. Now dear students, we have practiced two examples of interrogative sentence, number one and two. Now we will go to our next sentence pattern, it is imperative sentence. So look what is written here, it is imperative sentence. Rules number one, following rules have to be followed in changing a direct speech into an indirect one. So look here, request, request, requested, order, orders, ordered, command, commands, commanded, or advice, advises, advised, is used as the meaning of the reported speech requires. Look at the other formula or process. Object, if any, to is used in place of inverted comma, base form of the verb, extension. Okay, look, structure, subject plus request, request, requested, order, orders, ordered, advice, advises, advised, tell, tells, told. Okay, object, if any, to base form of the verb of the reported speech plus extension. Look, look at an example of direct sentence. He said to me, please give me a glass of water. That means here he is requesting. That means we will use the word request. He requested me to give. So look here, I written to, then the base form of the verb, to give him. Here me represents he. So look here, here me represents him. He requested me to give him a, I'm writing object, glass of water. Look, I am telling the sentence again. He requested me to give him a glass of water. So look here, here written requested, since the word is past. He requested me to give him a glass of water. Now imperative sentence rules number two. If the imperative sentence is negative, the verb with infinitive is to is preceded by not. Look at the example. The teacher said to the students, don't tell a lie. That means this sentence is negative. Okay, look at the indirect example. The teacher advised. So you will insert advised. That means this one advised, okay. The teacher advised the students not. So look here, it is written not, not to tell a lie. So look, the teacher advised the student not to tell a lie. Now rules number three. When someone is addressed in the imperative sentence of the direct speech, it is changed into an indirect speech according to the following structure. Structure, addressing plus object of the reporting verb, if any, as the word used to address the person, subject of the dash. Now dear students, we will go to our next base. So look here, reporting verb plus reporting verb to plus main verb of the reported speech plus extension. Look at the example to have a clear concept. So look here, it is written, he said to them, friends help me, friends help me. So you will write here, addressing them as friend. In our structure it is written, addressing them as his friend, addressing them as his friend, he, friends help me, that means he requested, he requested, Addressing them as his friend, he requested them to help. To help him. So look at the example, indirect example. Addressing them as his friend, he requested them to help him. Now another rules, rules number 4. In place of sir in the direct speech, respectfully is used in the indirect speech. Look at the direct example. The boy said to the teacher, the boy said to the teacher, sir, lend me your book, please. Now look. The boy requested the teacher. The boy requested the teacher respectfully, since sir is written, so we will write the word respectfully. Respectfully to lend him. Here him represents to boy. His represent teacher. To lend him his book. Look at the board. The boy requested the teacher respectfully to lend him. Here him represents boy and his represents teacher book. Okay, now rules number 5. This one is use of let. So look, very important rules. Following structure to be followed in changing a direct speech of imperative sentence with let into an indirect one. Structure: subject plus proposed, that, they, we should, main verb of the reported speech plus extension. For here it is, note is given here, if the subject of the reporting verb is in third person, that is followed by we. Okay. Direct: he said to me, let us go out for a walk. So look here, he said to me, let us go out for a walk. Here we will use proposed. He proposed to me so look here, he proposed to me, then that we should, he proposed to me that, here it is written that, so look here, he proposed to me that, here written we, so look here, look at the formula, we should go out for a walk. So look, he proposed to me that we should go out for a walk. Here written subject, then we have selected this one as the tense is past tense. To me, it is written to me, okay. Then that is given, that they plus we, okay. Since the sentence is us, that means we represents. There is no third person. As a result, we have taken here we. We should go out for a walk. Now we have, with this example, we have finished our imperative sentence, all the rules. Now we have optative sentence. So look, to change a direct speech of an optative sentence into an indirect one, following structure is followed. Very easy, you have already known this. Subject: wish, wishes, wished. Pray, prays, prayed. That, subject of the reported speech, plus might, plus main verb of the extension. Look at the direct example. Father said to me, may you pass the examination. So what will you write? Father said to me. Here we will write father prayed. Prayed. So look here. Wished or prayed. Father prayed that. Here you represents me. Okay. You represents me. That means I. Father prayed that I. Then the past form of the may. Pass from the maze might. I might pass the exam. After might, we know that there will be the present form of the verb. Pass the exam. Examination. So look at the example again. Father prayed that I might pass the examination. Very common rules. Now we have exclamatory sentence. So look here. If joy is meant by the reported speech, exclaimed with joy. Again, if sorrow is meant by the reported speech, exclaimed with sorrow, or grief is used. That is used in the place of the inverted comma, subject of the reported speech, verb according to tense, very or great, then the given adjective. Extension, subject plus exclaims with joy, with sorrow, as required by the meaning of the reported speech, that subject of the reported verb plus very great, then adjective of the action. Very easy, these are the very easy structures. Now look at the examples of direct. So look here, Sylvia said, what a fine bird it is. So look, Sylvia said, what a fine bird it is. So you will write, Sylvia exclaimed with joy. Since the sentence is positive, Sylvia exclaimed. So look here, we have taken the past form, exclaimed with joy. Joy that the bird was fine. The bird was fine. So dear students, look here, Sylvia exclaimed with joy that the bird was fine. Now dear students, I am telling the example so that all of my students of class 7 can understand the examples of interrogative sentence, then imperative sentence, then optative sentence and exclamatory sentence of narrations. So in the interrogative sentence we see, I am asked his sister if she would go to school, full stop. He asked me where I lived. Now look here, he requested me to give him a glass of water. Next, the teacher advised the student not to tell a lie. Now we'll go to next page. Addressing them as his friends, he requested them to help him. So look here, It is taken in the past formula, okay? Requested. Now another rules here. The boy requested the teacher respectfully to lend him his book. Little bit below we have another example. He proposed to me that we should go out for a walk. Now look, father prayed that I might pass the examination. I have written here so that you can understand examination. Now our last rules of exclamatory sentence of narration. Sylvia exclaimed with joy that the bird was fine. So look here, the bird was fine. Very easy and clear example, the bird was very fine. Exclaimed with joy that the bird was fine. Dear students, look at the end of our book. So look, it is written homework, narration, interrogative sentence, rules, structure and examples. Dear students, no need to write all. That means I have given SUR SW narration interrogative portion. So look here, which one is interrogative portions? Only these portions you will do SUR SW. Rules number 1, then rules number 2. So look here, I have written, you will write the rules number, then structure, then the examples. No need to write all the sentences. My dear students of class 7, hope all of you have understood this important class. In our previous class, we also discussed narration. That means we have performed or we have learned two classes regarding the narration to have a clear concept. Dear learners, look here I have given my messenger ID, this Abul Kalam. If anybody has any query, I am telling, if anybody has any query regarding our today's class or previous class, please write me in the comment box. And finally, do your homework in your homework copy and abide by your parents' advice. See you again, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.